Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today's topic, I had gotten a question from someone who was a little bit concerned that their resume applying to nursing school was a little bit bare. And there's nothing wrong with that. You know, we're all applying to nursing school at different ages, different types of experiences or lack of experience. So I thought I would just come on here and see if I can provide or spark some details of what to put on your resume, because I wouldn't recommend to just leave it bare. I think when you're writing your resume, it really shows what you have done or what you have not done, and it really can give you time to either start doing things or know whether or not your resume is how you expect it to be or the type of information that you want to present. But of course, if you don't have as much experience, there's not as much to present, which is completely okay. But I think there might be some other things that you can put in place of the typical work and experience and stuff like that, just to spice up your resume a little bit, because I wouldn't recommend just saying, okay, well, I don't have any work experience or I don't have any volunteer experience, and kind of just like leave it at that. Because it's definitely important to put something more, just put some more stuff in there and not just the typical, like, I have good grades and, you know, all that stuff. So, in my opinion, when a nurse is someone that is well-rounded. They're well-rounded as far as their education, personality, world experience, working with patients. You're looking at care for your patient and for yourself as a whole. It's not just health-wise, it's, you know, environmental-wise, lifestyle, stress, all that encompasses in your care. So when you're presenting your resume to apply for a school for nursing, your resume should reflect that. It's not a matter of just getting stellar grades. That can't be the only thing. You have to have more substance in your resume. And I think when I have talked about my how to write a resume for nursing school, I have another video on that if you want to check that out for the basics. But if you're having trouble figuring out what to put, or maybe you don't feel like you have enough substance in your resume, I'm trying to think of some ideas that might help you be like, oh yeah, I remember doing that, or maybe spark some new ideas. First and foremost, you need to have good grades. We all know that. You need to have, you know, a stellar GPA. We don't need to go over that because everybody knows. So as far as more substance, you might want to, if you are applying to nursing school straight from high school, or you did like dual enrollment, or you're in your gen ed requirements / prereqs right now, and you're still younger, maybe you haven't worked before, you don't have a lot of volunteer experience, I definitely recommend, not necessarily just go out there and get a job if you don't have time, but I definitely recommend that you do some sort of volunteer work, whether it's in the healthcare field, or maybe you want to work with somewhere in the hospital, or maybe you want to do, work in just any type of volunteer thing. It's definitely important to have something like that. You want to work that you want to show that you're contributing to the community, that you are working with others, that you're taking your time and prioritizing your time to help others. It's important to show that, because if you're just worried about school and nothing else, that's not being well-rounded. So, of course, I definitely recommend to have some sort of work experience if you can. I had made a video before talking about my jobs before nursing school. So I worked in sales. I worked as a CNA. I have my certification in phlebotomy and medication aid. So I have dabbled in different things that has helped me learn about time management, working with people, having a paycheck, working as a team. Working as a team is extremely important, and schools want to see that. Can you work with others? Can you not get frustrated? Can you not freak out on someone because you don't know how to work with people? As a nurse, or anyone in the healthcare field, or really in any job, people want to see that you can work as a team. Because you are going to be working with other people, you're going to be working with other colleagues. And if you can show that to them in one way or another, and that doesn't always have to be through work, it can be through a volunteer experience. Maybe you played competitive sports, you're working as a team, you're showing people that you can do that, even if you don't have the typical job experience is what I'm saying. If you're applying to nursing school, like I said, either from high school or you're just, this is your first degree and you don't have much experience, you can even try joining a club or a sorority or a fraternity and maybe becoming the president of that or the treasurer or whatever terms that they have, being part of a team. You can sign up for volunteer experiences with Susan G. Komen. You can work for, have experience in the American Red Cross, volunteer at the hospital. There are tons of volunteer opportunities out there. You just have to search for them. I definitely think doing that maybe like once or twice a month, or you know, just showing that you are working with people, working as a team, is huge for them, because that's what you're going to be doing in nursing school and as a nurse, is working and working with people and working as a team. They don't care if you're making money or not. They want to see how you're going to work with others. And how are you going to work with your teachers and professors and other students? That's important for them to know. So if you have anything like that, that would be great. Maybe you were in high school and you did dual enrollment. Did you get any awards in high school? Did you do any competitive sports? Were you in the band? Were you in orchestra? Were you a dancer? Were you playing soccer? Like, what other things were you doing other than the studious school part? And if you're not doing anything other than the studious school part, you really need to if you want to apply to nursing school. Because I believe that they're looking for a well-rounded individual. And yes, while grades are important, life is not just about that. You have to experience other things as well. So I'm just trying to think of any other ideas. You know, getting awards, being in a club, an organization. Another thing, now that I think about it, there are plenty of professional organizations that you can join as a student, and sometimes they cost a fee, but usually they're cheaper when you are a student. That's extremely important to be a part of, especially in the healthcare field. They have, you know, American Nurses Association. They have specific ones for different fields, like for pediatrics or for neonates or whatever you're interested in. Being part of that is definitely very important as well. I'm trying to think of what other things that you can put in your resume. Maybe you even started your own organization, or maybe you raised money for a cause, or maybe you even made masks for the pandemic. You know, things like that that you've done to help the community, that you've worked as a team, that you're working with people, that's so important to put on there. Don't leave that out thinking that that's not important. It's extremely important, and it's showing schools and potential places that, you know, you're out there in the community, you're working with people, you're doing good, you know, and people want to see that. And I don't think, some people might be like, well, but that's not a big deal, but it is, because not everyone's doing it. And you want to make sure that your resume sticks out and is unique and doing things that maybe people don't expect. But you cannot leave it bare. You know what I mean? Do something about it. If you maybe are applying and you realize you don't have much time until the due date, but you don't have much substance, maybe wait and apply the next time and try to get some more substance, whether you're volunteering. It doesn't always have to be work, but just showing that you're part of something is really important, or showing your passion, or maybe you coach for your son or daughter's or someone's soccer team, or like, that stuff is important. It doesn't always have to be health related. If it is, then wonderful. And if it's not, that's okay too. Because, you know, you're essentially meeting the minimum requirement of doing your prereqs and whatever exams that you have to do in order to have the bare minimum. But you don't want to be the bare minimum applicant. You want to have some substance and show other unique things that you have done. Just like when I applied to nursing school, I was able to say I worked as a CNA, I worked in sales, I was part of this club, I you know, did different things. I danced in high school, I played the violin. Like, you know, you show that you're musical or into the arts, or that you're well-rounded, that you are doing more than just studious matters. You know what I mean? So you are able to show your uniqueness in your application, because if you think about it, all of these nursing schools have tons and tons and tons of, probably stacks of applications from different applicants. And if they're all going to be, okay, this person has a 4.0, this one has a 4.0, how are you going to differentiate who you're going to apply? because we're not going to do anything stereotypical where we're going to apply because this person looks better than this person. That's unfair and ridiculous. So what substance are you going to put into your resume that says, okay, this one has a 4.0 and so does this one, but this one has done X, Y, and Z, has been in plays, has been in sports teams, has gone back to the community, and this one doesn't have anything like that. Most likely they're going to choose this applicant because there's more to them than this one. Not saying that this person is necessarily better than this one, but on paper, this one is showing more. And of course, I don't know if nursing schools do interviews. I kind of don't think so at like a bachelor's level. But, you know, if they are not meeting you and your personality, this is the time to show your personality. I don't mean show your personality in terms of how you write or how you speak. You need to be professional with your application and your resume, but it shows what you're into, what do you enjoy, what brings you compassion, what brings you passion in life, you know, what are you interested in? And it's important because when you're dealing or working with patients, you're not just going to go there and be robotic and just give them their treatment and go. You need to be able to connect with people and talk about things and establish a rapport and have good time management and have like a well-rounded personality, because you're working with patients who want to feel good, who are feeling sick, and they need someone for comfort and also someone to do their job that they're supposed to do to keep them alive and healthy. So they're looking for all these different things. So if you have a bare resume, look back at everything that you've done. Maybe there's something that you don't remember, a document or a certificate that you got. Did you get any awards? Did you volunteer anywhere? It doesn't have to just be health related. Maybe you work in the humane shelter. That is still substance, because not everyone is doing that, and it shows that you care for the animals, that you want to help them. It's just going to translate into people now. You know what I mean? So don't feel like just because you don't have science or health experience that it's not worthy of being on your resume, because I really think that every single person, if you just look hard enough, you have something that you can put, but you may not think that it's worthy or important enough to put. And that's something where you're going to have to really sit down and think, okay, what volunteer experience have I had? What work experience have I had? What clubs have I been in? What have I been a part of? How did I give back to the community? And I bet you at some point you can find something that will bring you substance in your resume. If you really cannot find anything from different categories, you need to start something. And it doesn't have to be like you have to go and have a full-time job or anything like that. Go volunteer. You may love it and you may find your passion and you may want to do it more frequently, but you got to do something. You have to have some sort of substance. You can't just say, I got great grades and that's it. You just can't. And that's more for people that this is their first degree coming from high school, because again, you're young. You don't have all this experience yet, and that's fine. And some people have tons of experience, and that's fine too. So don't worry about it, but you need to really think, what do I have? Look more outside of the box of what you can put and see what you have to implement into your application. And if you don't, start something. Hey guys, it's just me editing, and I was just thinking that another thing you can put would be if you had shadowed a nurse, or if you've shadowed a CNA, or you've shadowed anyone in the healthcare field. Even though you haven't essentially, you know, worked or done anything, just your exposure there and able to see how the healthcare system works, whether it's outpatient, inpatient, nursing home, whatever it is, I definitely think that would be an important thing to put as well. And that's something that you can do if you, you know a nurse, you can go ahead and shadow them, and it's not something that you have to, you know, sign up for and apply and hope, you know, you get a position and stuff like that. So just thought I'd share that, and please continue watching the video. However, if you are applying to an ABSN program, you obviously have a degree, maybe multiple degrees. You probably have a little bit more life experience. You probably have more substance to put into your applications because you already at least have one degree. So for me, my previous degree was in biology. So I was able to go to different clubs. I had different experiences educationally. I volunteered, especially in the American Heart Association, in donating blood. you know, I was able to do things in that time because I was studying and I had other things to do. I was working also part-time. So applying to nursing school as a second degree individual, I had more life experience. I had more experience with education and volunteering and working and everything. So my application had more substance in it other than just good grades. So it's easier applying as an ABSN, especially if you've had multiple degrees or you're older and had tons of life experience, you have a lot to put. But if this is your first degree, you may not have as much to put, but that's okay. You know, you're young, you can't beat yourself up and expect yourself to have all a whole list of experiences when you were like born like 5 seconds ago, you know what I mean? So don't worry about it. But also, don't let it say, okay, well, I'm just young, I'm not going to put anything. No, you want to gain some experience, and it'll help you too. It'll help your resume. It'll just help your self-esteem and getting into school. So just if you're feeling like your resume is a little bit bare, take some time, think about all that you've done. Because you may not think, you might not have thought that it was important, but it really is. Whatever you can show to an applicant that you understand time management skills, that you can work as a team, that you work with people, that you're compassionate about something, that's important, whether it's healthcare related or not, because you can always translate it to healthcare later on. So don't overlook things. Don't think that something is not as important or doesn't give enough substance. It might be the most unique thing that you've ever experienced, and it might be the most unique thing that the applicant has seen. So be different. Be unique. You know, don't overlook things. I'm sure there's something you can put. And if you really think about it hard and there's not, find something to put into it because you can't leave it bare. So I hope that came up with some good idea or some sort of spark of looking back and see what you can put on your resume. It doesn't have to be traditional, you know, work, school, volunteer. There are other ways to show who you are, show your personality, show, you know, what you can provide and what enrichment and what you can bring to the table as a future nursing student. So thank you guys so much for watching. As always, if you have any topic you'd like me to discuss or discuss any further, please leave a comment below. If you have a more personal question about your own nursing journey and you don't want to leave a comment, you can go ahead and just email me straight. You don't have to leave a comment if it's more personal. I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful day. Remember to always believe in yourself, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Okay, bye.